Google DeepMind artificial intelligence learns a baby's understanding of physics. Neural network could be a step towards programs for studying how human infants learn. Inspired by research into how infants learn, computer scientists have created a program that can pick up simple physical rules about the behavior of objects and express surprise when they seem to violate those rules. The results were published on July 11th in Nature Human Behavior. Developmental psychologists test how babies understand the motion of objects by tracking their gaze. When shown a video of, for example, a ball that suddenly disappears, the children express surprise, which researchers quantify by measuring how long the infants stare in a particular direction. Researchers at Google DeepMind wanted to develop a similar test for AI. The team trained a neural network, a software system that learns by spotting patterns in large amounts of data, with animated videos of simple objects, such as cubes and balls. The software model, named Physics Learning Through Auto-encoding and Tracking Objects, PLATO, was fed the raw images from the videos, but also versions that highlighted each object in the scene. PLATO was also designed to develop an internal representation of physical properties of the objects, such as their positions and velocities. The system was trained on tens of hours of videos showing simple mechanisms, such as a ball rolling down a slope or two balls bouncing off each other, and developed the ability to predict how those objects would behave in different situations. In particular, it learned patterns such as continuity, in which an object follows an uninterrupted trajectory rather than magically teleporting from one place to another, solidity, which prevents two objects from penetrating each other, and persistence of the object's shape. At every step of a movie, it makes a prediction. As it gets further into the movie, the prediction becomes more accurate. When shown videos with impossible events, such as an object suddenly disappearing, PLATO could measure the difference between the video and its own prediction, providing a measure of surprise. The researchers say that PLATO is not designed as a model of infant behavior, but that it could be a first step towards AI that can test hypotheses about how human babies learn. They're hoping this can eventually be used by cognitive scientists to seriously model the behavior of infants. Comparing AI with how human infants learn is an important research direction. That said, the paper does hand-design much of the prior knowledge that gives these AI models their advantage. The next step for the researchers is to work on approaches in which the program develops its own algorithms for understanding the physical world. Brain-computer interface enables quadriplegic man to feed himself. The device included robotic arms and implanted microelectrode arrays. A new study published in Frontiers in Neurorobotics demonstrates how a brain-computer interface enabled a quadriplegic man to feed himself for the first time in 3 decades by operating 2 robotic arms using his thoughts. Brain-computer interfaces, also known as brain-machine interfaces, are neurotechnology powered by AI that enables those with speech or motor challenges to live more independently. This bimanual robotic system, controlled via a BMI in collaboration with intelligent robot behavior, has major implications for restoring complex movement behaviors for those living with sensorimotor deficits. A partially paralyzed quadriplegic man living with a spinal cord injury was implanted with 6 Blackrock Neurotech neuroport electrode arrays in the motor and somatosensory cortices in both the left and right brain to record his neural activity. Specifically, in the left hemisphere of the man's brain were 4 implanted arrays, 2 9-to-6 channel arrays in the left primary motor cortex, and 2 3-to-2 channel arrays in the somatosensory cortex. In the right brain hemisphere, a 9-to-6 channel array was implanted in the primary motor cortex and a 3-to-2 channel array was placed in the somatosensory cortex. The participant was asked to perform tasks as the implanted microelectrode arrays recorded brain activity via a wired connection to 3 128-channel neuroport neural signal processors. He was seated at a table between 2 robotic arms with a pastry on a plate set in front of him. He was tasked to use his thoughts to guide the robotic limbs with an attached fork and knife to cut a piece of the pastry and bring it to his mouth. The aim was to have the robotic arms conduct most of the task with the participant empowered to take control in some areas. The researchers hypothesized that this shared control of the robotic limbs for a task that requires both fine manipulation and bimanual coordination would enable greater dexterity. The robot was given the approximate location of the plate, food, and participant's mouth beforehand. Using neurally driven shared control, The participant successfully and simultaneously controlled movements of both robotic limbs to cut and eat food in a complex bimanual self-feeding task, reported the researchers. Ghost imaging combines human vision with AI to see around corners. It is often called cloning, which is a software-driven data backup process that copies the contents of a computer hard disk in a single compressed file or set of files, referred to as an image. And it is the process of creating data images of the content and configuration of a computer, server, or similar device. Researchers have shown that the computational imaging technique known as ghost imaging can be combined with the human vision to image an object that can't directly be seen by the person. Its AI system imaging creates photorealistic images from input text. It can reconstruct the basic details of objects hidden from view by analyzing how the brain processes barely visible reflections on a wall. Ghost imaging is also known as data imaging, disk imaging, or computer imaging. A ghost imaging system that reads the brainwaves of a person. Researchers at the University of Glasgow have demonstrated a ghost imaging system that reads the brainwaves of a person looking at light scattered off a wall to identify an object around a corner. The researchers performed a comparative study on the base of several challenging real-world scenarios, including a flying drone, and demonstrate that the proposed method outperforms other widespread ghost imaging methods. This is an entirely new visual phenomenon and provides a new tool to study the visual system. Ghost imaging has been used before to reveal objects hidden around corners. Although the researchers previously passively used human vision to perform ghost imaging, the new work uses the human visual system in an active role by having a person view the light patterns instead of a camera. Ghost imaging has little relevance for human perception since the human visual system must be incapable of processing this kind of data. This is one of the first times that computational imaging has been performed by using the human visual system in a neurofeedback loop that adjusts the imaging process in real time. The researchers showed that their technique could successfully reconstruct 16x16 pixel images of simple objects that could not be seen by the observer. The technique relies on clever algorithms to crunch the seemingly random data that a single pixel appears to gather. Repeating this process with different random patterns of light produces a sequence of data points about how the light intensity varies over time. Ghost imaging requires no additional viewing screen or computational steps. Ghost imaging with the eye opens up several completely novel applications, such as extending human vision into invisible wavelength regimes in real time. Ghosting can save hours of setup time compared with loading programs from scratch, and it reduces errors in the process. It is much faster than installing each machine separately, especially if it involves installing many applications. Considering that ghost imaging is a promising method for long-distance imaging, the proposed method has great potential for high-resolution remote sensing. And that's the roundup of the AI news for today. Make sure to like, subscribe, and enable the notification bell for the latest news in artificial intelligence, robotics, and brain-computer interface news. And thanks for watching.